Hello, this is Stephanie from my pastorciexam.com. I know it's devastating to fail the CIA exam when you've made a big investment in terms of time, money, and effort. If you're serious about getting this done, let's go through this self-evaluation on what possibly went wrong, and more importantly, how you can pass in your next attempt. Most frequently asked question. Part 1 and Part 2 were a breeze, but I failed Part 3 twice. Why is that? And what should I do? The IIA does not disclose CI exam pass rates, and I don't have data to back up my claim, but I do believe a lot more candidates fail Part 3 of the CIA exam. Not only does Part 3 cover substantially more exam content, most topics are also outside of internal audit and auditing in general. This goes beyond most candidates' comfort zone, and they cannot answer questions based on their practical experience. To add to the difficulty, questions tend to be more lengthy and tricky as well. The good thing about this part, though, is that almost all topics are at the awareness level, meaning the basic and introductory level. What candidates can do for effective preparation is to go through all concepts, especially the new ones first. Then, work on the theoretical questions, followed by the computational questions as extra practice. You'll likely need double the time to prepare Part 3 when compared to Part 1 and Part 2. With sufficient time to practice, this is doable. Now, let me walk you through the common mistakes that candidates make for all parts of the exam. Four most common reasons why you fail the exam. I have to say, almost all candidates fail the exam because of the following. Not enough time to study. Not enough effort. Not able to grasp the concepts. And not able to complete the exam within the testing period. Let's go through these one by one. Not enough time to study. Unless you pursue the exam right after graduation or even before graduation, chances are that you have juggled your schedule between study, work, and even family. Let me ask you, did you manage to study all the topics in the review course? Or did you finish but kind of skim through the materials without going into the details? If the answer is yes, then congratulate yourself, because you have found the reason of your exam failure. Here are my suggestions. Complete the coursework. Continue to study where you left off, and work on the practice questions to make sure the concepts sink in. Find your weaker areas using the performance tracking tools. Most of the online test prep software have built-in performance tracking where you can easily identify your weaker areas. These sections should be your top priority, and make sure you redo the wrong ones and don't stop until you get them right for the right reason. Utilize your idle time. Have you tried waking up an hour earlier for this study? If you have a long commute, you can make use of the idle time reviewing the materials using flashcards, lecture notes, and audio reviews on portable device. Here's a collection of ideas from successful candidates on how to find more time to study. Create a more efficient study mode. Sometimes it's hard to study at home where all the temptations are around. I know quite a few candidates go straight to the library after work and have a quality study time for 1 to 2 hours. You might want to try that. Not enough effort. Seriously, have you put enough effort in your study? Ask yourself whether you really understand the materials and the concepts behind them, or you kind of read through the text half-heartedly and forgot half of the stuff the next day? Another example. For the 2 hours that you have allocated for the study, did you dive straight into the test prep software? Or kind of first check your email, grab a coffee, and log into Facebook, and then reluctantly work on a few questions in the last 15 minutes? Again, don't let these temptations stop you from getting the qualification you deserve, and all the benefits that you are going to enjoy for the rest of your career. Here are my favorite motivational quotes to drive you succeed in your exam, career, and life. Not able to grasp the concepts. You know you've spent enough time and effort on the exam and you still failed. So the next possible reason is that you didn't manage to understand the concepts after all. Is the review materials too general? Or is it too complicated to understand? You are most welcome to drop me a note and we can discuss further. Not able to complete the exam. Besides study strategies, exam taking strategies is important too. Many candidates seem to have failed because of poor time management. To put it simply, they were not able to complete all the questions in the exam. The best way to solve this is to work on as many practice questions as you can so you can get used to read, think, and answer the questions in the same format as the exam. This means that you have to practice online in a simulated testing environment. Some of you may be thinking about walking away and giving up. This is the last thing you want to do. The score doesn't reflect your ability. It could simply mean some lack of study time and quite likely some luck. If you keep going and push a little bit harder on your next attempt, I'm sure you can nail it. You will find more tips on how to deal with your specific exam below this video. You are welcome to share your story here or directly on my website, and I'll try my best to help you out. Take a good break, spend some quality time with your family and friends, get recharged, and move on. You can do this. I look forward to hearing good news from you on your next exam.